On performing arts and technology. Opisipisenga siva mametau technology. Malona o ngā I lawa wina o ringan Samoa. So I hope to first share some insight on how I think that we can use this to our advantage. It's nothing new, LSMFO. Samoans and Polynesians have been using this technique for thousands and thousands of years. But I hope to show how we do it here at Le Fetuao and to have some feedback from you guys later on in the presentation. So the roadmap for this talk is I'd like to if I spa matalang kultura may wing on performing arts, but pispesenga masiva fa Samoa, malona taua, ilusenga sa olingam Samoa, onoso aile masiva matalang kultu we wing at mea technology. And then the main part to do is a sample activity. So sort of a workshop with all of you here. Hopefully you'll be you'll oblige me to sort of just show how we carry out some of our lessons in our classes at Fetuao and in the Masenga Siva. And at the end, I'd like to show you some student examples that have been produced by some of the students that will be helping me today. Lily. So why performing arts? Asia bisbiseng asia siba. Ya ole atula tato symposium ya o ngatasi le kutia marumele. Ya yo ngatasi le ngana malanga nu ale ise ngana ile ise nganu. Ya if I been afo ile ile bisbiseng o siba. Ale ise bisbiseng ya ile ise siba. And within that performing arts is where the language thrives. If you have no language, then you can't sing. If you can't sing, you can't dance. And then you have, without the language, you don't have culture. So, o iaso ana muala aile I tau nuu mai missionary sa moa mai Hawaii nei, ele I aini tusu tu singa, e mawhai o nga mawai mea tāua sa te tupu I tono tātou atunu. Ia, o pesepesenga masiva la, o se awala tāua lawa lea na, sa mawhai ai o nga tātou tu ngutu ma tu talinga, le poto male atamai o tātou tua āua mawai, I lea tupulanga, I lea tupulanga. And so that continues today. We continue that methodology today in our classrooms, and that's our purpose. It's not just for entertainment, but it's to pass down knowledge. It's a way of recording and helping our youth to carry on this these traditions from generation to generation. So, olealo na o ngā ilivasenga. Olealo na o ngā ilivasenga Samoa I one of the key things that I have found useful for this is mnemonic devices. So mnemonic devices is a kind of big word, but olona wima o awala ia mafai ia na mana tua e tamaiti upu fou. So strategies for helping the children to remember new vocabulary, and I think that as Polynesians, we have this already in a sort of packaged form for us to give to our students. And the first is ole upu. Le upu, just the word itself. Ospaitai te ingala, upu ata. If we're trying to teach this new word ata to the kids. So the first mnemonic strategy is you have the sound of the word ata. Olona lua, ole winga. And in the class, I try to avoid just direct translations from English, because I believe that English developed and evolved in a completely different environment than Samoan did. So instead of thinking of Samoan in English terms, we think of it in its true meaning, in Samoan terms. So ele faunga le le upu English po le upu fa palangi ai faunga le ata o le winga la o le upu ata. So you have the upu. Ata, ole winga, olona tolula, ole pese, ole pese. So they have the sound of the word ata, they have the image in their minds of ole tenele ala ata, and then they have, you can add the song to ole pese. So, spekta to ingo ole pese, ata, ata maya, yamana, yalo tato aso, right? So then they have ole fati ole pese, o se peso soani lea, mana tuaye, tamaiti le winga ole upu, male upu fo. Male device lona fa o le siva. So not only do you have the word ata, the image of ata, the tune ata, but then you have the dance move itself. So if we sing the song ata ata maya, and the move was this.
Ata ata maya, ata maya iya mana iya lo ta ta wa.
So if I go fia le tango de pesi, it's also, it really helps the kids to remember what ata is. So that's how I found that performing arts is useful in the classroom, because it offers, it maximizes the potential mnemonic devices to help kids remember and for it to stick not only in their brains, but so in our Vasenga Siva, we try to use this strategy with the children, and we also try to bring in technology. So why technology? Aisiale technology. It provides an interactive venue for the children to stay interested, so to do hands-on learning. And we use iPads and laptops for them to learn how to record music, how to make music videos. So when they're doing it themselves, it will stick even more within them. Not only is it interactive, it's also communicative. So it provides opportunity for the students to actually use the language while they're doing the projects. And then finally, it's relevant. It's relevant to their age. They're the generation that has grown up with iPads and iPhones and all this great technology. So we should take advantage of it and have it be something they're comfortable with in the language as well. So one of the other main things is that we don't often think of instrumentation as technology, but it is a form of technology, I guess. And so one of the strategies we use is teaching different types of instruments, not only the singing and the words, but also traditional Samoan instruments. So we'll look into that later today, but we have ukulele, fala, pate, timbalan, selo, and incorporating that into the lessons to help them even further. And then finally, the main portion of the technological part is the digital storytelling. So they're able to teach them how to use these programs. The main two that we use is GarageBand and iMovie. The reason for this is that they're easily accessible. So they come on every Mac, iPad, and MacBook. And also they're user-friendly for the kids, they're easy to learn. So we teach them how to record these songs on the GarageBand and then transfer them into iMovie, where they make music videos, where they retell the story of the song in their own unique way. And so that's sort of its application in the classroom. So a summary of our methodology at the Fetuao is that in the performing arts, we try to maximize these mnemonic devices to help the kids remember their words and the meanings. So we have upu, reata, pese, lusiva. And then on the technology side, we teach them different instruments, and then ukulele, pate, fala, to finally put together a digital story from their own perspective, and that will hopefully stick with them through using programs like GarageBand and iMovie. So that's sort of a brief summary of how our approach is for the Vasenga Siva. But now what I'd like to do is to actually show you how we do it in the classroom. So if you'll oblige me, we're going to just do a little interactive activity. Okay? So one of the other things that I like to add is the stories that every omea umataua e tutupu I sa moa e yeise pese. E yeise pese whamatala ai nā mea poli mea mitupu I nā taimi. So I try to use songs that have connections to legends, so that not only are they getting the language, the music, but also the stories and the history of our culture. So ole le sona le ole atam fayatu ni, o le e amata ile tala, o le tala le ya sina ile ma sina. O le tala lea ya sina ile ma sina. This is the story about Sina and the moon. O Sina e poto ile fainga o le siapo. Sina is very talented at making siapo. Aisa fa no no tele o ia, but she was very sad. Awa ele ai lava se mea ai usiang tama, because she had no food for her son. Sina then looked at the moon and said, come, so my son can eat you. The moon got mad. How dare you say that you want to have me be food? Na luifo masina maave sina malana siapo ile masina. Se yo maile aso eva aye sina ile masina olo faila malana siapo. Ya ole talala ya sina ile masina. So let's start with just the story about simple story na fa faingo fia ina le le tala awale ngano o tamaiti. So the story, and then it goes with a song. So I'm going to teach you this song now. O se pese fai ngofie lava. O le a o usu atu le laina mua. A uma si tato pese fatasi. Laina mua. Awele ai lava o se mea ai. Masina ua mana yeleba ai. O se Ole laina mohua la awe ele ai lava o se mea ai. Ia ele tatou pufou ele laina mohua na o tatou pufou lea. Sei, mate mai po lale tatou upufou lea.
Awe.
Awe, le, awe. Pai fatasi tatou awe.
Awe.
Le, awe. Ia laina mohua awe ele ai lava o se mea ai. Laina lona lua, e lua tatou pufou ma sina o ilea. Ola tatou pufou lea.
Masina.
Masina, lei masina. E a lea?
Ma'ai.
Ma'ai, lei ma'ai. Ia. Awe le ai lava o se mea ai, le masina ua ma'anaya I le ma'ai. Le laina lona tolu, tatou pufou lea. Ola ala le tatou pufou? Matau. Matau tia. Matau tia. Ah, matau tia. Lei. Ia. E whāra tātou pufou. Si tātou tō e usu, tasi ar peselea, awe I a.
Awe le ai lava, o se mea ai le masina ua. Mana ia le vai, o se mea e matau tia.
Fonga, le, ya, ah, umala upufo, umal tala, umal pese, ya ona ule tato siva.
Popo tato,
got the four mnemonic devices, the word itself, the images, the songs, and the tana, the motion. So we have awe word, awe picture, awe tune, awe, and awe tana, awe. Yeah? So those are the four different strategies that hopefully after the fourth time, the students will have it in their brains. Awe means this, right? Hopefully. Okay, so now what we add is our afaili, our band. So I'm gonna ask our students here to pass out some of our ukuleles. If those of you would like to try, fa'ukulela. We'll start with ukulele. So at Le Fetuao, we're very fortunate to have these ukuleles that we were able to purchase through the ANA grant that the students use. We have 20 total, and we use these each tech camp, and the kids even get to take them home. They can check them out and practice at home, and then bring them back for class. So today, we get to have fun with them and use them as well. So, Ele, oli ukulele, oli ukulele. Ola fesilila, ole a lenga ngana, esa waile lea ukulele.